This is Brandon Lee with BetVerums.com here with your 2012 Denver Broncos football predictions. The Denver Broncos miraculously made the playoffs despite a 1-4 start last season. Tim Tebow took over at quarterback in Week 7, leading the Broncos to wins in 7 of their next 8 games. Their 8-8 finish was good enough to win the AFC West division and to earn a first-round home game against the Pittsburgh Steelers. Tebow put forth his best game of the year against the Steelers, guiding Denver to a 29-23 overtime victory. They would get blown out by the New England Patriots the following week, but it was still a very successful season to say the least. Now, Tebow has been traded to the New York Jets, and John Elway went out and signed four-time MVP Peyton Manning to take over at quarterback. Denver put up 19.3 points and 317 total yards per game last season while leading the league in rushing. The offense will take on a whole different look in 2012. It will still try to keep some sort of balance, but there's no question the Broncos will air it out a lot more this year. Manning suffered a neck injury that kept him out all of last year in Indianapolis. Surprisingly, the Colts let him walk, and the Broncos wasted no time taking advantage by signing the franchise quarterback that Elway has always been looking for. There's no question that Manning will be motivated to prove that he can still play, and I have no doubt he will do just that provided he can stay healthy. Running back Willis McGahee is coming off one of his best seasons yet. He rushed for 1,199 yards and 4 touchdowns in a run-heavy attack last year. He enters his 10th year in the league at age 31 and has shown little signs of slowing down. But look for Knowshon Moreno, who had just 37 carries in 2011, before going out for the season with a torn ACL, to take on a bigger load this year if he can stay healthy. The receiving corps doesn't have a bunch of big names, but this unit will certainly be improved with Manning running the show. Eric Decker figures to get the most targets and is primed for his first 1,000-yard campaign. Demaryius Thomas came on strong last year and figures to sniff the 1,000-yard mark as well. Matt Willis and former Cincinnati Bengals wideout Andre Caldwell will figure into the mix. Jacob Tammy, a former Indianapolis Colts tight end, was handpicked by Manning to join up with his former teammate. The Broncos have one of the best young offensive lines in the game, and the entire front five returns intact. This unit is led by left tackle Ryan Clady and right tackle Orlando Franklin. Also back is left guard Zane Beadles, center J.D. Walton, and right guard Chris Cooper. Manning will feel very comfortable with these five protecting him on Sunday. While Tebow received all of the credit for turning the Broncos' season around last year, you could argue that the defense was equally responsible for their resurgence. Denver gave up 24.4 points and 358 total yards per game last season, but during the stretch where it won 7 of 8, the stop unit yielded 15 or fewer points 5 times. This is an excellent pass-rushing defense due in large part to a defensive line that features defensive ends Elvis Dumervil and Robert Ayers. Nose tackle Ty Warren returns from a torn triceps that landed him on the IR in August. Defensive tackle Justin Bannon has been signed from St. Louis to add some strength inside. Rookie second-round pick Derek Wolfe figures to see the field plenty in his first year. The linebacker corps features strong side linebacker Von Miller, who earned Defensive Rookie of the Year honors last season after being selected in the first round in 2011. Miller turned out to be everything that Denver hoped he would be and more. Middle linebacker Joe Mays and weak side linebacker DJ Williams resume their starting roles. Weak side linebacker Wesley Woodyard adds solid depth. Corner Champ Bailey enters his 14th year in the league at age 34. He'll play opposite corner Tracy Porter, who comes over from the New Orleans Saints. The Broncos also added Drayton Florence from Buffalo. He and second-year pro Chris Harris bolster their corner depth. Strong safety Quentin Carter played pretty well as a rookie. He'll be joined by free safety Mike Adams, who comes over from Cleveland. Now for my AFC West prediction. I have the Broncos winning the division with a 10-6 overall record. Manning not only makes the Broncos a favorite to win the AFC West, he also makes them a legitimate Super Bowl contender if he can stay healthy. Due to winning the division last season, Denver will have the toughest schedule of all the AFC West teams. It has to play both Houston and New England, which each won their respective divisions. I still believe the Broncos can overcome this schedule and finish just ahead of both San Diego and Kansas City. Manning will actually have a running game to take some of the pressure off his shoulders, which is something he was missing in Indianapolis. Denver also boasts a solid defense that can get after opposing quarterbacks. I really like the additions of defensive tackle Bannon, corners Porter and Florence, and free safety Adams, along with a healthy return of nose tackle Warren. Manning will find a way to lead the Broncos to the top of the AFC West in 2012.